Hello everyone and welcome to Gob's Haven. Let me start with a demo. This first feature is by using Smart Life app control. This one is by voice command with Siri. Hey Siri, remove the sun protection.
Okay, done.
The other controls available will be shown later. For now, allow me to show how mechanical components are positioned. You will see two colors of cord that serve as actuators for closing and opening movement. Winding black is for the closed movement, white cord is for open. This is the cord drum coupled into the reversible motor. In counterclockwise direction, the net opens by pulling the white cord. As it happens, black cord is unwinding. White cord is tied into the GI pipe frame of the net to both sides. Yes, there are two pairs of cord for open and close. Black cord installation is quite straightforward. The pair of black cord pass through the pulley at the center and to a sort of cord positioner going to the main cord drum. The white cord pair for open movement is passing through a pulley on the extreme sides. This ideally is the extreme open position of the GI pipe frame, so the closer we get to the pipe extreme sides of the greenhouse, the better. For the manual control, I provided a button so I can always operate the shade net whenever I wanted. I also provided an emergency stop in case needed. At this time, the movement happens and it stops until it reaches the limit switch installed on sides. I will try my best to show you the rest of the mechanical stuff I have in this greenhouse. At this part, you will see the limit switch that turns the rotation of the motor when the GI pipe touches the extreme open position. This is necessary to signal the system to cut the power, thus protecting the motor and the cords. Similarly, this is the part at the center that contains the limit switch for the close position. When the shade net is at closing motion and reaches this limit switch, motor stops. By the demonstration and showing you some details on this greenhouse, I hope you figured how the mechanism works for my shade net. For the automation part, please refer to my previous videos. I use two Tuya socket controller that is pretty much within my power requirement to meet my desired operational sequence.